Yeah, good evening to all of you. We are now starting the micro irrigation methods. Two important methods under this micro irrigation is one is sprinkler and one is a drip. Of course, of late the micro irrigation methods taking a lot of interest by the users because they saves a lot of water but still its application is very limited, particularly in India less than 2% is only applied. So let us go for these micro irrigation methods, first sprinkler and then for the drip. You can see this sprinkler irrigation. Sprinkler and drip irrigation methods. Sprinkler and drip irrigation methods are quite different from the methods described hitherto, in the sense that these two methods involved in no open channel flow in carrying water to the plant, but is carried by piped flow. So that is the fundamental difference. Whatever the flow that is being there, so far we have seen both surface as well as of course, to some extent, not in the subsurface, but all the surface flow methods. Open channel flow is main thing. Whereas in the case of sprinkler and drip irrigation methods, it is a piped flow. So that is necessarily under certain pressure. It's not that it is not under pressure. So definitely they require some energy for this. That is what we mean to say. So, for that, there are somewhat costlier. It's not under gravity flow. We have to lift the water from some source and then distribute under pressure. That is the thing in both the methods. Another important difference is land leveling is very less. Of course, in the case of surface methods, you have seen both in either in a border strip method or in other check basin methods, land leveling is very must. But here, it's not that much land leveling. Some kind of leveling is needed, but it's not a very scrupulous land leveling. Some land leveling is needed, no doubt. Very less, you see, another important difference is land leveling is very less and very high initial investment. Again, it takes a lot of money to install these methods. But again, irrigation efficiency is very high. You see, when compared to surface irrigation methods, efficiency is high. For example, if with a given discharge of water, it is irrigating around 1 acre or 1 hectare, then more than 50% or 60%, you can double that area. In fact, some places it is two times, three times more than the normal flow irrigation, that is surface methods. Okay, so these are the some of the advantages. Of course, some disadvantages also there. Except that high initial cost, there is not at all any disadvantage. In fact, many people have reported the yield is high and also free from some kind of diseases also when you are irrigating these fields, particularly in the under surface methods. They have to use many there was attack of pests, but with the drip irrigation methods, these pest attacking is less. That is what people said, and the quality of the agriculture produce is quite good. Anyway, there are advantages, no doubt. People are using slowly but steadily. Okay, so in this method, water, we are now talking about sprinkler irrigation. In this method, water is sprayed into the air and allowed to fall on the ground surface, resembling the rainfall. And particularly in the sprinkler methods, what we see is we are creating a situation or creating a water spray, so almost something like rainfall, the resembling a rainfall, the controlled spraying of water. The spray is developed by the flow of water under pressure through small orifices. Basically, the spray is created by allowing the water to flow, flow through orifices and nozzles, or it is also called nozzles, orifices or nozzles. The pressure is usually obtained by pumping. Okay. It is becoming more popular in the regions of water scarcity where available water is insufficient. Even today, the particular impediment for this popularization of these methods is the water is not so scarce, nobody is going to invest so much and then trying to put these methods. Particularly, it is more popular when water is scarce and they want to save the water. Only in that context they are being used. So that is why still its spread is somewhat less in the developing countries. Whereas in developed countries, okay, they have expanded fast. Since the irrigation efficiency is very high, much higher area can be brought under irrigation. That is a factor we have already talked about. It is suitable to almost all crops, sprinkler method, except rice and jute. Of course, where standing water is sometimes required. But even in, I have heard from Microsat, even the rice can also be grown. This method is not not so much unsuitable. Even rice today, modern rice also coming with this kind of irrigation. However, this method is not usually suitable in very fine texture soil like clay, when clay is very dominant, because infiltration is very less, so whatever the little water you are spraying, particularly it is not allowing to infiltrate. So where infiltration rate is less than 4 mm per hour. The method is particularly suited to sandy soils and for deep, slopy or irregular topography. This is where mostly the method is applied. I have visited Rajasthan in very sandy soils, and the water is also somewhat salty. They are applying for growing crops. The limitations of this system include highest initial investment as compared to surface irrigation methods. Many of these things we have already discussed. High power requirements, clean water free of sand and wind distorting of the sprinkler patterns. See, one of the discouraging things is when the wind is too much, then the sprinkler method get distorted, the patterns, the wetting patterns get distorted. That's one thing. But clean water is required because it's very fine orifices. You know, in these fine orifices, even a small, either grain or some other thing is simply embedded, then entire sprinkler gets spoiled. So this is about the sprinkler, its adaptability to various situations. Okay, then let us go for the components of sprinkler irrigation system. You can see here the pump and then main pipelines, laterals, risers, sprinkler heads. These are the main components of the sprinkler system. Of course, there's some minor components also we'll come back later on. First, pump. Pump is very much required because already we have said it is under pressurized flow system. So first of all, the water has to be pumped from the source. The source may be a tube well or even a bore well or some other source, even from canal, any other thing from somewhere. And then it has to be lifted and put into the pipes flow under some pressure. Okay. So it is required to lift the desired amount of water from the source of supply to the highest point in the field and maintain adequate operating pressure. This pressure is required. This is very much important in sprinkler or in drip. Okay. So to push the water through main pipelines, laterals, risers, and then sprinklers. So then main pipelines. These are the pipelines laid in the field to carry water till the laterals. I will show you one figure. What is a main pipeline and what is a lateral? after this slide. If the system is permanently set up in the field, they are normally buried underground. Normally it is advisable, suppose you are going for a permanent setup, main, at least main pipelines, it is better to lay it underground rather than simply shifting every time. So portable mains are more economical. Portable mains are more economical when a sprinkler system is to be used on any number of fields. For portable lines, lightweight aluminium pipes with quick couplers are used. So portable mains are economical when system is to be shifted from one field to another. So normally aluminium pipes with quick couplers are used. Steel pipes are used for most permanent main lines. So when you are going for a permanent main lines of the system, that means when the from that field we are not shifting, then some steel pipes are used. Asbestos cement PVC pipes are also used, but concrete pipelines are not adapted. This is very important. Concrete pipelines are not adapted to use in a high pressure sprinkler system. Lateral lines. These are the pipelines connected to the mains to carry water up to the risers. The lateral lines are usually portable. You can see this one. This is the method where you will have this suction pipe, the source, and then a pump, centrifugal pump or some other pump, engine, diesel engine. Sometimes a power line may not be there. You may have to put diesel engine, then gate valve, pressure gauge, then bend. This is the main line. Okay. Then from the main line with a T coupling, lateral, lateral this is. This is the first lateral, like the severe lateral. So this is the main line, and lateral lines are with the T junction, it will be connected. With another T junction, a riser will be there. This is the riser. And these are the sprinkler heads, the small ones seen here on the top. Of course, end plug is there. So the sprinkler, this is the total layout of the sprinkler components, all. So component, so now we have seen, in the lateral lines, these are the pipelines connected to the mains to carry water up to the risers. The lateral lines are usually portable, quick coupled. Aluminium pipe is best for most portable laterals. So generally these laterals are many times, they are movable. They should be movable because only main pipeline if it is permanently laid, that is okay. But laterals many times they have to remove and then fix somewhere. You cannot fix a lateral also underground many times. So permanently also the people are putting, if you are permanently arranging, that's good, but it is always better, it's movable ones. So aluminum pipes are resorted to. Buried permanent laterals are however used for some orchards, trees, orchard trees, nurseries and other, where when you can say this is the orchard and then the nursery is there, definitely you can put these lateral pipelines permanently. The lateral pipes are usually available in lengths of course, 5.6 or 12 meters each. Then risers. These pipes rise above the lateral and carry the water into sprinkler heads. The risers, I think we can go back here. You can see already you have seen here riser. This is a riser. This is a lateral. Okay. So these pipes rise above the lateral and carry the water into sprinkler heads. The risers are normally connected as T-joint to the lateral and rise up to the required level above the crop. Mostly lightweight aluminium pipes are used. So here both for the lateral lines as well as the risers, you can use for aluminium pipelines. We will stop here. We will continue in the next video. Thank you very much.